Hey everybody. This is the set that's gonna get a little weird. Alright, so I've been working on these songs and I'm gonna invite Mr. Borja, Mr. Norton up with me, and eventually Rob and Mr. Manns, and we're gonna have some fun tonight. So this song is called Coyote.
A call from a coyote seems to agree. And then transcending, I strive to see, strive to see a boy of ignore all the signs. Thank you.
don't really play these songs, so this is kind of fun. This one I wrote, I don't know where it's going to live, but I played it in North Carolina, if any of you were there. This one's called The Good Old Days.
Here we go.
Got it.
stereo. Listen as we go. Nothing's gonna stop us now. California, here we come. Right back where the stars come. To the core, thinking of the war, gotta bring us to the show. California, here we come. Right back where we started from. California.
Hey, so what do we do? Want to, you want to do another one, Mike?
Yeah. We're going to do that other one. Suddenly, I'm not half the man I
to hide away, though I believe in yesterday.
DJ was right. DJ was right.
What did he just say?
It's crush on you. It's so beautiful. We all got crushes on Borrow.
Yeah, man.
The little bear.
Okay, what do you think? You want to try this one? You have the course map? You want to try it, or?
Sure, let's give it a shot.
That's in background.
Oh, God. I don't even know if I can read it.
Oh, my gosh.
I don't mind.
Do we have a anybody got a printer?
No. Okay. Throw me my reading glasses.
You got it?
I went spot. I think I know.
Well, there goes my girlfriend. Lost everything I was good in your life to the toss of the tides.
Let it go, Martin.
We did it all the time.
I'm trying every day.
Like, you want to try yours?
Sure.
Is that the Howard Jones?
Sorry. Sorry. That was here too. Where?
Alright, let's hear it for Mr. Borhawk and this. Yeah, we're gonna see how that apple case really works. Oh, it's out of the case. The case threw it out of itself.
We got this guy.
Y'all need more apple juice?
It's a good thing that Mike has that apple endorsement.
Everyone's like, ooh, it's gonna fall down.
No high octave solos, Mike.
Security is there. Then you are.
Hey, Jason, what are we looking at his time?
Jason?
Jason?
About like 5 hours.
Is it 5 hours?
What is time?
Okay, that was great.
Come down here from Loud and Swing. I'm Rob Benedict, and maybe some Jason Hands too. Let's get them all on the stage. We need help.
All right, so what are we doing?
Yeah.
What are we? Why are we here? Why are we here? The Great White Oven?
Yeah, you guys do the verses. I'm just gonna sing chorus.
Okay,
chorus.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I'm up there watching these guys. I give up Billy Moran. We'll see. And then Mike Borja. And then Norton gets up there and this is what these guys have been doing in the green room and I'm not there. I come in, I'm like, so have you learned Gunpowder and Lead? And they're like, no, but we can sing this Beatles song. that was so great. I had this weird sort of like, I don't know, I guess it's like we're brothers. I was going to say parental pride, but I'm not like a parent to them, but it's like more like brotherly pride with the three of them up here, and it was really fun. Okay. Dad. It's like dad's.
Woo, Ron!
We're gonna do a song here off of my solo record. There's a Borja at the window.
There's a light in the attic, a hole in the tin. The rain still gets inside. Daylight saving is here, making days disappear. Groom has left his bride. Songs and I've said this before, but it's real and like it may, and I don't know, it makes me, it's therapy for me, so anyway, thank you for caring.
was this man on my doorstep. He said, sir, you best wake up. There's a great wind coming. As it blows, it won't let up. Station break songs. I want to send them to you. And he's like, send them. I'd like to put out right here and right now, tipsy on a little bit of whatever that shot was. There's going to be a Station Breaks album in the not so far away future. For a while, Jason wanted to put out the Station Breaks Greatest Hits album, which was just the first album we released.
One new song.
Same order,
one new song.
Wait, Mike, you have to use
I bought the hell out of that.
Feel the snake in the valley. Stay back down with the gear on the way. Maybe I'll go outside fire. If they catch me, put me away. I used to say, it's got potential. Now I'm away, no way. 6 more miles in my state. 5 more ways to make my game. 4 suitcases.
Special, the band is all, we're riled up, and we're like, we go 3 drinks at
we're
least
drunk.
On Saturday night, yeah. We're just like all fired up, we gotta be up and up. He goes to bed first, glass of wine, then he goes up to his room. I come to visit your hometown, and it's a drink factory. You're my favorite man. What the fuck was that? Was amazing. Coffee in it or some shit? A little bit of caramel pineapple?
It's just all
sugar
and
stuff. Yeah, cheese. Chris, the one that Tick got me?
Pineapple?
We need to talk about it.
You don't need to stare at her eyes. That's true. Just a moment, though. That's got to tell
the
story.
Jason and I were training for the marathon, and we're also on the tour. So we came here, him and I went running, and we came back, and he's like, check your body for ticks. I was like, I was running the entire time. How are there ticks on me? And I found like three. And one of them had really dug in there.
In a sensitive area.
It was like right here. It was pretty far up there. And I had my shorts on. I had my running, I took my shorts off, I had my running shorts on. But Krister, God bless her, got in there with the tweezers and worked on that thing.
Which I felt like was a medical procedure until you reminisced looking into her eyes this morning. Do you remember? It wasn't as good for you as it was for me.
Meanwhile, Krista forgot about the whole thing. It's all I can think about. But no, but it's true. And I actually ended up getting like a test to make sure that it didn't like infect me or whatever. Yeah, Lyme disease test, because it stuck. The head of it got stuck in there.
Sorry.
She said that's what she said.
This has gone out of hand. I blame that last shot on that story. I'm just kidding, Chris, but it was actually all that's true. So this is not kidding.
I feel like while he's switching to his electric or his other guitar, I feel like it's probably a good time to tell this story. Recently, I was on this stage. You may have remembered it. It was the first show. And I was tuning my guitar. And my wife came up to me with a very concerned look on her face. And I thought she was going to tell me that like something's broken, or there's a policeman outside, or there's too much noise, or something. And she walked up and she said, I can see your balls.
And anyone else?
When I remembered that my
pants were split down here, torn open.
Yeah, but because I was lifting, moving some furniture, and I'm not small. And luckily, I had underwear on, but still. So, you know, the point of the story is, you know, find somebody that's going to watch your back and your front. Watch your back.
And right there in the middle.
Yeah. She's got Billy, are you ready to go?
Yeah. Jason, he's got an eye on your back.
Thank you.
wanted to see how long he could go.
Oh, good. When he started, I was like, okay, good, we're done. We're done. Norton, we're done.
Thanks, everybody.
Yeah.
I think
yeah,
we have this stuff. We're going to stage it the next performance, so we have to start at 7:30. So we're going to take a break and then come back at 7:30. And even when the stage runs out, you're going to get bonus stuff. We just want to make sure that that starts at the right time. So,
but you're
going to
do one more station break song? Is that what you said?
We'll do more station breaks.
Oh, yeah.
There might be
more station breaks.
Yeah, there'll be lots of stuff. Yeah, what?
The rest?
The rest, oh, sure. Yes. The rest, request for the rest. All right, we'll be back in half an hour.
Oh, no.